Everybody on. I hope you all are fine. Welcome to our mathematics class. My dear students, we have started chapter number 8, that is fractions. In the last sessions, we have already learned about how to write a fraction of a shaded part and unshaded part, right? In the concept 8.2, we have learned about what is like fraction and what is unlike fraction. Do you remember? Can you tell me what is like fraction? The fraction with same denominators called as like fraction. And the fraction with different denominator called, yes, unlike fraction. Right? So this we have already learned in concept 8.2. I hope you understood all the session related to chapter number 8, that is fraction. My dear students, have you completed your mathematics workbook of concept 8 and 8.1, 8.2? Yes, both worksheets. Still, if you have any doubt, then you can contact me or message me. My dear students, as we have our PT2 exam, right? And this PT2 exam starting from 13th up to 18th. We are conducting this exam online, like in the form of Google form, right? In that, we will be having 20 questions, each question having 4 options, right? Same like PT1. Okay, so now do your study very hard, very carefully, right? If you have any doubt, then contact your subject teacher, right? So my dear students, today we are going to start a new concept, that is concept 8.3. See, concept 8.3, and this concept is nothing but, what is concept 8.3? Add and subtract like fractions. Okay, today we are taking only like fractions. We are not taking unlike fraction, because we have to do two arithmetic operations. That is, the first one is addition and second one is subtraction. So are you ready? Yes. Okay. Open your notebook and write down concept 8.3. Add and subtract like fractions. Okay. Done. Right. How we can do addition? How we can do subtraction? With the numbers that we have already learned. Right. Same method we have to follow for today's only. Okay, for addition and subtraction. But here we have a different word, that is like fraction. We have to do our addition and subtraction not only with numbers, we have to do addition and subtraction with like fractions. Like fractions means what? As we have already learned, the fraction with same denominator. So my dear students, we cannot do addition and subtraction with unlike fraction. If the fraction with having different denominator, then we cannot add or subtract. Whenever we have to addition or subtraction, we should have a like fraction. Understood? So shall we see in the brief? Yes? Okay. See, I have written one example number 1. Can you see this figure? As we are thinking about, the teacher is always drawing the same figure, right? Okay. See, we have this figure. One whole, you can take one square shape or you can take any star shape. Okay, see, I have taken one circle, one whole, and one, if you can see carefully, this circle is divided equally into some parts. From this again, I have shaded some parts with the pink color and some parts with the blue color. So what is your question? Yes, we will see. In the given figure, find the fractions. From this figure, we have to find the fraction. Whose fraction? Represented by the shaded parts. We have to find out the fraction of shaded part by using addition. Okay, what we have to do here? We have to do here addition. By using addition, we have to find out the fraction of shaded part. So, are you ready? Yes, as we have already learned, whenever we are just writing the fraction, what we will do? We have to write the fraction of whole figure. See, this is a whole, and this whole is equally divided into some parts. How many parts? Part number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So this whole part is divided equally into 8 parts. So this thing we have to measure, like total number of equal parts. How many equal parts we have? 8. So we will measure here. Total equal parts are 8. Now they are asking about the shaded portion, shaded part. So that shaded part we have to count, right? So I have written already number of parts colored by pink. If you can see carefully, here we have how many parts that are colored with pink? 2 parts. So I will mention here how many parts are colored with pink? 2. Next, again we have one more color, that is blue. So that also portion we have to mention, right? So I have written number of parts colored by blue. So how many parts are colored by blue? 1, 2 and 3. So I will mention here number 3. So see, my dear students, number of parts colored by pink are 2. Total number of equal parts are 8. So can you tell me the fraction for pink color? Fraction for pink color is 2 by 8. And fraction for blue color is 3 by 8. Why 3 by 8? Because the part that color with blue are 3 and total number of equal parts are 8. So that only we have to write a fraction representing the shaded part. So can you help me to write about the fraction represented shaded part? That is fraction of pink color. Can you tell me? 2 by 8 plus, why plus? Because we have to find out the fraction represented by shaded part by using addition. So we have to mention here plus. Okay, next color is blue. The number of parts colored by blue are 3. So can you tell me fraction for blue color? Yes, 3 by 8. 3 by 8. Done? Clear? Now let's see the two fractions, the fraction with pink color and fraction with blue color. Have we same denominator? Denominator, is it same or different? It's same. With same denominator, it means these both fractions are like fraction. And if they are like, so we can add easily, right? 2 by 8 plus 3 by 8. How we can add? Simply, we have to add numerator. Okay, from 2 by 8. What is the numerator? Numerator is 2. Denominator is 8. From blue color, we have a 3 numerator and 8 is in denominator. So whenever we have to add, keep your denominator as it is. Denominator is number 8 as it is. And what we have to do? We have to simply add numerator. So add number 2 plus 3. Answer is 5. So you are getting your answer. Fraction representing the shaded part is 5 by 8. Understood how to add? Yes. Okay. So this is about the addition. And same thing you have to find out for subtraction. For subtraction also, we have to subtract the numbers from numerator only. So shall we do subtraction in this example also only? Yes. What we have to find out? See, we will get here fraction representing the shaded part. So can you calculate fraction represented by unshaded part? Unshaded part? Yes. Very good. So we will mention here. In the bracket we will mention, because it is not in our example. We are just discussing about how to find out by subtraction. So here we will mention fraction represented the unshaded parts. So how can you calculate the unshaded parts? So before calculate unshaded portion, first we have to find out the fraction of whole part. Then what may be the fraction of whole part? Denominator is the number 8, because there are 8 equal parts, right? And how many parts we have taken for shaded and unshaded? In the how many parts this whole is divided? Is 8 only, right? So we have write same number 8 in the numerator. Understood why? Because what we are mentioning in the numerator, the parts which are taken, right? The parts which are taken is in, we are mentioning the same number in numerator, and denominator total number of equal parts. So the total number of equal parts are 8, and we are counting how many parts? Again 8. So that's why the fraction for whole is 8/8. From that we have to cut the fraction of shaded part. Then after all this we will get the unshaded portion, right? So what we have to do? We have to minus from that whole. We have to cut this shaded. Okay, from this whole. Whenever we are subtracting, if we cut the fraction of shaded part, then but obviously we will get the fraction of unshaded part. So what is the fraction of shaded part that we have already calculated? Fraction representing shaded part is 5/8. So shall I mention over here 5/8? Okay. So now do your subtraction. How can you do subtraction? Like addition. Don't think about denominator. Denominator keep as it is and subtract the number from numerator. Subtract only your numerator. 8 - 5. Answer became 3. So now change your answer. Change your fraction in the figure. 3/8. What is mean by 3/8? We get the fraction of unshaded portion. Unshaded part. 3/8 means total there are 8 equal part. Right? Total there are 8 equal part. Alright. In numerator we have a number 3. So from that figure, 3 parts are there which are not shaded. Just check. See, part number 1, part number 2 and part number 3. Right? The answer is matched in the figure. Only 3 parts are there which are not shaded. So understood how to do subtraction and addition of shaded part? Right? Addition we are writing over here and subtraction we write in the bracket because it is not done the question. Okay? So are you ready to solve more example based on addition of fractions, subtraction of fractions? Yes, just keep in mind one thing. We can do addition and subtraction only with like fractions. Okay? Good one. Like that we have example number 2. What is example number 2? Addition. What we have to do? Add. Example number 8. 3/8 + 1/8. Can you give the answer? 3/8 + 1/8. What I told you? For addition, don't think about the denominator. Keep the denominator. Check out. Both having same denominator, it means both are like fractions. Right? Okay. So write down denominator as it is. And whenever you have to add, you have to simply add the numerator. 3 + 1. Answer became 4. So what is the answer of 3/8 + 1/8? Answer is 4/8. Same for example number B. What is example number B? 4/30 + 5/30. Again, what we have to do? Write down denominator as it is and add only the numerator. 4 + 5. Answer is 9. Very good. The answer is what? 9/30. Same for example number C. 1/9 + 2/9. Write down 3 by 9. Getting? How to do addition of like fractions? It simply put denominator as it is and do the addition of the numerators only, like how we add numbers. Understood? Okay, so this is about example number 2. One more example we have, that is example number 3, which shows subtraction. We have to subtract. Example number 8 is 8 minus 9 is equal to minus 4 minus 9. Shall I write it again? 8 minus 9 minus 4 upon 9. For subtraction also, we have to follow the same procedure. Put the denominator as it is. What is the denominator? Denominator is number 9. And subtract only numerators. 8 minus 4. Answer is 4. Very good. 4 by 9. For example number B. Example number B is 33 upon 37 minus 25 upon 37. Here also we have a like fraction. Correct? So put the denominator as it is. Denominator we have is 37 and do the subtraction between the numerators. 33 minus 25. Answer is 33 minus 25. Answer is 8. Very good. So the answer of subtraction is 8 upon 37. Same for example number C. Can you solve example number C? What is example number C? 11 upon 15 minus 6 upon 15. As we have same denominator, it means they are like fraction. Put the denominator as it is and do the subtraction of numerators only. 11 minus 6. Answer became? Yes, 5. Very good. Okay? So this is about how to add and subtract like fraction. Understood? Okay? Shall I give you homework? Very good. So, in the textbook, we have an example on the page number 16. So, I will mention. Shall I mention over here? In this box, homework. Homework. Shall I show you? We have our textbook, page number 16 and 17. On the page number 16, we have question number 6, which show add. And on the page number 17, we have question number 7, that is subtraction. I will mention here, homework, textbook, page number 16 and 17. Solve question number 6 and question number 7. In that, we have a like fraction and we have to do addition and subtraction. Okay? So, my dear students, today we will stop over here. The remaining part, that is word problem, based on addition and subtraction, we will see in the next session. Till the time, thank you.